Welcome everyone to another Mixed Media Tuesday, and today I'm creating an art journal getting inspiration from this new collection by Stamperia. This is called Klimt, and I do have a separate video of unboxing the release. I will upload that video today as well, so check it out if you like. For today I'm creating a mini journal. This page is 5x7 and this is thick watercolor paper. I'm going to start by working on my background, and one of the best ways to start if you don't know what to do on a blank page is to use rice paper. That's what I'm going with today. I'm using one of the rice papers from the Klimt collection by Stamperia that has beautiful patterns. I like to rotate the rice paper to decide which part of it I want to work with, and then I'm going to stick everything down using my matte medium. You can go with any collage glue that you have at home, and I'm going to make sure that I apply a generous amount both on the actual paper on the page as well as on top of the rice paper. I will make sure that this is completely dry, and then I will use my scissors to chop off the excess, and of course I will save the rest of the rice paper to use it on another project. Now, as much as I love the patterns on the background, I still want this to stay in the background, like being quite muted and not competing with the colors that I'm going to add on top. That's why I'm going over in some areas with white paint, and I'm doing that with my brayer. You can see I'm just using my jelly plate here, just as my mat. It really is helpful when you are using your brayer. Now, I always like to have a kind of a darker border on my layout, so that's why I'm going with black distress ink all around the edges. And you will see that I'm going to do a lot of things. I will work a lot on this background until I'm happy with it, so I might go back with some of the techniques. Now I'm using one of the stencils from the same collection, and I'm going over it with white embossing paste. I like to work with very thick embossing paste, and my favorite by far is the one by Altenew. I made sure that I have some of the designs in different areas, quite organic. I didn't cover the whole thing. And while that embossing paste is drying, I'm going to work on my focal points. So from the 6x6 paper pad, I know that there is a little page with lots of tiles, little parts from Klimt's art that are made into tiles. I'm going to cut them out with my scissors so that I can use them as tiles again on my project. I absolutely love Klimt's paintings. I love all those beautiful patterns and the way he incorporates those three-dimensional figures in flat patterned backgrounds, and I'm so happy that I get the opportunity to play with those patterns in one of my pages. Here I'm just doing some dry brushing. The color that I'm using is ivory, so it's off-white color that is going to blend nicely with the rest of the design, and I'm going in some areas here and there just to mute them down. As I'm working with this collection, I know that I cannot use already perfect images to make them better, so all I'm thinking at this stage is to just how incorporate his beautiful art into my journal and make a page kind of like a tribute to his work, of course through my own artistic touches. And of course you cannot use Klimt images without adding gold, so here I'm using gold acrylic paint, again with dry brushing. My brush is completely dry, it has no water at it at all. This is gold metallic acrylic paint by Stamperia, and when you tilt the paper it catches the light and it is shiny. And since I have all that gold on my glass mat, I'm going to add some splashes as well. And of course I did dilute the paint with water for that step. And since I'm into splashes, I'm going to add some black splatters as well. Don't ask me why I decided to do that, sometimes ideas just come to my mind and I have to do them. And back to inking up the edges with black ink. After doing all these layers, I kind of lost that darker edge that I was going for. And now this is the 8x8 paper pad. I'm going to use one of the girls as my focal point. And I'm just going to fuzzy cut around here. Really easy to cut her out. And then having all the cutouts ready to go is just a matter of putting everything together. And here is where I didn't realize why my glue became so thick and it was oozing out. I was trying to glue everything down and I was just making a mess. And this is where I realized that this is not my glue. Instead, this is white acrylic paint. I was able to clean up everything with a baby wipe and back to it again, this time by using matte medium to stick everything down, not to make the same mistake again. Things like that happen to me all the time. The process in my videos looks perfect, however, it's not, trust me. I am as human as everybody else and things like that happen to me all the time, but video editing is my best friend. And if you are enjoying my videos, don't forget to click the like button as well as leave me a comment. These are just a few ways to support any YouTuber that you like by interacting with their video, since the algorithm by YouTube has been kind of crazy lately. By the way, the matte medium that I'm using at the moment is the matte medium by Liquitex. I usually go with the Ranger one and I was using that for ages. However, I ran out of it and I did have the Liquitex. That's why I decided to use that as well. I find it very handy because it's so liquid and I can use it directly from the bottle. I'm also going to cover up completely the whole thing, not only the girl underneath, and that's because I'm planning to do some shading and highlighting with my big brush markers. For that technique to work, I need to make sure that everything is non-porous. And I'm making sure that this is completely dry, nothing is wet on my page before I go ahead and use my markers. And these are the kind of markers that I usually work with. These are by Faber-Castell and these are the big brush markers, as I call them. They are from the Pitt range. But I wanted to show you today that you can either go with a smaller version of them. There is no need to go for the bigger, which are the more expensive ones. I do have a set here of the smaller brushes and they come in different sets. I have here a bigger one, but you can get smaller sets if you like. I'm going to take one out so you can see the difference. These are the exact same markers, they just have a different barrel and of course a smaller brush nib. The smaller ones are marketed mainly for calligraphy and they are widely available in many different colors. And I'm not going to do the shading today with my big brush markers, instead I will use the smaller ones so you can see that they work exactly the same. I'm always using a marker which is darker than the actual color on the paper. And you can go even darker if you like, I'm going to show you here. The darker the shade, the more dramatic the look you're going to get. I love them because they dry permanent. They don't cover up what's underneath, but if you don't have them, you can definitely do shading with your watercolors, of course on a porous surface, so you wouldn't have to cover everything up with your matte medium. The only difference is that with these markers you get really vibrant results. And you will see how all those images are going to pop against the background. I did zoom in for you so you can see better what I'm doing. Here I'm going with an even darker brown marker to add the shading which is closer to her head and this is going to pop her even more. And of course I repeated the same technique for her dress using browns and reds. And then I used my thin black marker and I'm just sketching some lines around her. Just to give the look and feel that I always have on my pages. And of course I'm going to grab my white gel pen and add some highlights in different areas of my cutouts, not too many but just enough to bring the whole composition closer to my style. And of course I always like to have some kind of a quote on my art journal pages. That's why I decided to go with the word art. I'm going to put it together by using this Chipboard alphabet set, again from the same collection. I'm picking the letters A, R and T, however I don't like how they stand out against the background. And this is where I decided that I'm going to use them because I like their shape, however I'm going to cover them completely with black. That's an alcohol marker. And of course having those letters black are going to really stand out against all the rest of the colors. And to complete my quote, I'm going to combine it with one of my stickers from the Small Talk booklet that says, "Darling, you are a work of art." So instead of using the typed word art, I just put it together by using the chipboard letters. Now, here are some little details that I don't like. I don't like how shiny the letters of the word art are, just because I went over the chipboard with my alcohol marker. So I just grabbed a buffer and I went over them to do some scratches. Now it's not shiny at all, and I absolutely love the effect. I'm also going to outline my sticker quote. And I'm so sorry that this part of the video is out of focus. I was paying more attention on my actual work rather than on my camera. And it seems that it wasn't cooperating. Anyway, I'm going to put that back into my art journal. And you will see some clear close-up photos at the end of this video. Before I say goodbye, I want to let you know that I cannot promise that I will post Mixed Media Tuesday for the next two Tuesdays, since I will be enjoying holidays with my family. I will be creating art journal pages for sure. I just don't know if I will be able to find the time to video edit and post everything online. So thank you all for watching today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired, and Merry Christmas to all who celebrate.